started with photography?
I think, you know, as crazy as it sounds, I think it's my dad joining the military that really got me into it, because when we moved, when I lived in the same area for so long, I had zero reason to, like, pick up a camera and to, like, document the same things I've seen every single day. So when we moved, you know, that's when I first, like, I grabbed, like, you know, this old ancient, like, digital camera and was just taking pictures everywhere. And when I moved to Texas, my best friend's mom was actually a photographer, and I just thought it was, like, I never knew that, like, photographers, like, other than, like, the people you see at, like, Walmart or Sears could, like, make a living doing that. So ever since then, ever since that point on, even when I moved again, I just, like, took my digital camera everywhere, and then, like, I would just take crazy pictures of me and my best friend and edit it on, like, you know, Picnic and Photo Bucket and all that. And then, you know, by my senior year, you know, I got my first, like, actual camera and was like, wow, I really want to do this for a living, so... I definitely enjoy couples. Me being in love, I guess as corny as that sounds, I like to recreate their love too on, like, camera, and I like seeing them interact with each other, and I just love seeing their love together. I feel like when you look at a picture, it's like, wow, they're in love, and I really want that, and I want to smile like that. I enjoy families. I like seeing big, happy families that are, like, who unconditionally love each other, who are crazy. Me coming from a big family, I like being able to see them interact with each other and be goofy and actually show, like, their sass with each other too. I love that. Children, I love their eyes, like their big expressive eyes and their face and their little smiles that they do. I like, I don't know, I just like enjoy capturing them smiling at the camera because they look so innocent and you can tell the world hasn't affected them yet and they just look pure and innocent. Seniors, I really enjoy shooting that too because you can make them look so beautiful and for them to get ready to graduate and everything, have the world in front of them, and I just enjoy seeing them who they are. I like to incorporate to show who a person is. I don't like to show, like, I don't want to, like, have them to be who they're not. I like to shoot how they really are. I definitely enjoy sports and, like, event work. With sports, I really enjoy doing football. I know I probably don't look much like a football photographer, but I really enjoy doing it. I love the action and the fast pace of it. And I've been doing a lot of work with, like, the Humane Society. I did one for pit bull awareness, and I got to shoot all the pit bulls with their costumes and stuff, and I really got some rewarding images from that too. And yeah, I like shooting all of those things. I just think the end result is my favorite, like how you went out and you produced such a great image and how your client or whoever you're shooting really looks at it and like, wow, I look beautiful. Because, I mean, that's what every person should feel, and that's what I want someone to feel like is, wow, I feel and look beautiful. Because I know how hard it is, especially in today's society with young girls and how they have to feel and look a certain way. And I really want to just take, you know, I want people of all different, you know, sizes and shapes and how they look different. I want to be able to say, like, well, she looks beautiful, but so does she. I don't want to, like, take pictures of the same type of person and say that's the only product of beauty. I really want girls and even guys or anyone, I want them to, like, look in the mirror like, wow, I look good. I don't want them to feel anything else or anything less than that.
Tell me about how you feel, how you prepare for a shoot.
I'm always extremely nervous with every shoot. I could probably do the exact same shoot, exact same location, exact everything, and every time I would still be, like, incredibly nervous. I prepare as much as I can, but I know as much as I prepare for it, like, something's gonna change, so I have to, like, work through it, so I don't, like, completely rely on preparations. Basically, what I just need to know is location and who I'm shooting. I usually try to work through it as best as I can, like, I come up with ideas to have a general idea, but, like, when you're in the moment, you never, like, think back to, like, oh, well, I looked at this image, so that's what I want to do. You kind of just, like, work with how what they're giving you also, because you can come up with the most elaborate posing, and if they're not comfortable doing it, it's just going to come off as really awkward. So I try and work them in to looking comfortable mostly. I don't, like, want to, like, just, you know, straight off the bat, like, we'll do this, they're going to look really, like, uptight. So I try and just do as natural as I can.